Ronnie Dapo was born on May 8, 1952 in Plattsburgh, New York. His family had moved from Pontiac, Michigan to California when he was 5 years old. Ronnie recalls, "My mom was on the bus showing pictures of her kids. A lady named Lola Moore was on the bus that day. She asked if I would like to audition, and my mom said, of course, oh, absolutely. The audition was a success. Lola Moore became his agent. In 1959, he was cast in the film 30, starring Jack Webb. He was in 3 episodes of The Andy Griffith Show. He is best remembered for playing Arnold Winkler and Opie and the Spoiled Kid. He was about 11 years old when the episode was produced in 1963. In Opie and the Spoiled Kid, Dapo's character, Winkler, throws a world-class hissy fit.
I don't want to lose my brand new bike. I just got it.
The directors gave Dapo a few takes to really work himself up. They'd say, just give us a little more. By the third time, he was pretty much screaming. And when the director yelled cut, he thought it might go again. Instead, the whole place stood up and applauded me. And he said, parts like that were great.
Ronnie Dapo, the Spoiled Kid. You know, I got a nice hickory stick out there in the drunk. Ronnie Dapo.
How y'all?
At Mayberry Days, I had time to chat with Ronnie, who played Opie's friend on the Andy Griffith Show. We are about the same age. We had some interesting conversation about his childhood experiences working on TV shows. I asked him what he remembered about working in the studios. He told me about some great times on the Warner Brothers backlots where he worked as a kid in shows like Cheyenne, Sugarfoot, and Maverick. Quite an interesting fellow.
I ain't got no guitar and I can't sing right now, so...
Happened with a few others.
So I'm going to tell you a story, a short story you might like. When I started acting was 59 and I signed with Warner Brothers in 1960 on a 5-year deal. And going back that far, when you work with different people, you tend to be in a certain group, like the one other studio, there's several different things going on, but you do them individually and you get to know people. And when Desi Lou called up and had me do Opie and the Spoiled Kid,
I want my bike!
Episode. Of course, I played Opie. Thank you! Is this over? But when I did that, I remember I came out of makeup. It was about 7 in the morning, and I heard this old guitar scrubbing actually, and kind of followed the sound, and sure enough, it was Andy Griffith. And I looked at him and I was kind of puzzled because he was sitting in a chair playing the guitar, but that didn't puzzle me. What puzzled me was he was in his shorts, his underwear, tiny whities, you know what I mean? Nothing with the imagination. And people were walking by him nonchalant and starting a new job. You have a certain, like your first day of work, everybody's got a little anxiety. That put me right to rest. This is going to be the most, you know, relaxing place I've ever worked in. It was. I actually had a lot of fun working with the crew, and it was unique. And I'm so proud to have a little taste of that and be with y'all good folks today, because there's so much other things that this country's going through right now. I think we need more Andy Griffith shows. I had to go to Virginia, so I didn't get to stay here very long, but this year I'm partying. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll see Michael's show and Karen's show, and we're going to have a beer.
Yeah, Ronnie's doing a show, too.
Yeah, I heard it like 2:15.
No, 1:30. That's Ronnie Shell, S-C-H-E-L-L, Shell.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Ronnie.
In 1966, Follow Me Boys was filmed, the best movie ever made featuring a Boy Scout troop, in my opinion. It was Kurt Russell's first movie role, starring Fred McMurray. During these days, I would have never noticed that there were 3 actors in the same movie who also appeared as guest stars on Andy Griffith's show: Ronnie Dapo, Arnold Winkler, Dennis Rush, Howie Pruitt, David Allen Bradley as Trey Bowen, and Polly Bear, Mayor Stoner. In the movie, Ronnie Dapo was Tiger. Dennis Rush was Jimmy. He left the entertainment business when he was 14 years old. From that time, he worked as a touring musician and was employed with day jobs such as steel framing and running a printing press. He retired at the age of 60. He is now 70 years old and lives in Denver, Colorado with his wife, whom he has been married to for 51 years.